Good morning. Today we are discussing the reactions of phenol. Reactions of phenol. First one, nitration. Nitration. Nitration means reaction with nitric acid. Okay, yeah. Nitration with dilute HNO3. Dilute HNO3 at room temperature. Okay, when phenol is treated with, dilute HNO3, okay, dilute HNO3 at room temperature, we get a mixture of orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol. We get a mixture of OH, NO2, orthonitrophenol and OH, NO2, paranitrophenol. Okay, so this is the first case, nitration. And in nitration, first is nitration with the dilute HNO3 at room temperature. When phenol is treated with the dilute HNO3 at room temperature, we get a mixture of orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol. Okay, this is orthonitrophenol and this one is paranitrophenol, Okay, now we can see that the volatility of orthonitrophenol, or you can see that orthonitrophenyl is more volatile than paranitrophenol. Okay, the orthonitrophenol is more volatile than paranitrophenol. What is the reason for this difference in the volatility of orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol? We know that all this is based on the force of attraction present in the molecule. What type of force of attraction present in the orthonitrophenol and what is the force of attraction in paranitrophenol, whether it is within the molecule or between the molecule. If the force of attraction is within the molecule, the force of attraction is weak, and if the when we compare, if the force of attraction between the molecule is present, you can see that that is less volatile, because the force of attraction is between the molecule. That means the force, the molecules are joined together by means of a force of attraction. That means its volatility will be lesser than that of those is present in the within the molecule or intramolecular force of attraction. So look at here, in the case of orthonitrophenol, the force of attraction is intramolecular hydrogen bonding. The force of attraction is orthonitrophenol. So I can write orthonitrophenol first. Or see, look at here, OH and NO2, as we have studied, N double bond O, O minus, and here it is H plus. Okay, you can see that this is our orthonitrophenol. In orthonitrophenol, you can see that there is OH, that means O is partially negative, H is partially positive charge. Therefore, you can see that this H plus and the O minus present in the nitro group, they will make a, they will have a force of attraction. And what type of force of attraction is this one? Intramolecular, intramolecular hydrogen bonding, intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Okay, hydrogen bonding. Okay, that means this is within the molecule. The OH group present here and the NO2 group present is here. Between these two moieties, OH and NO2, there is a force of attraction. What type of force of attraction is this one? Intramolecular hydrogen bonding. Here OH, this is H plus, and here you can see that NO2 means N double bond O, O minus. Therefore, this is a force of attraction between this H plus and O minus. This is what is known as intramolecular hydrogen bonding. But when you come to paranitrophenol, okay, look at here, this is ortho, this is ortho. And when you come to paranitrophenol, look at here, here it is our OH, and here you can see that N double bond O, and here it is O minus. Okay, this is the first molecule, and again I am writing one more molecule. I am writing here it is N double bond, okay, double bond O, and here is O minus N plus, here it is O, H O H. Okay, here it is OH. Now here you can see that here is OH group. Okay, here is the OH, and of course in OH group this is delta negative and hydrogen is delta positive. Therefore, what will happen? The O minus present in this molecule and the H plus present in this molecule, neighboring molecule, will have a force of attraction. That means here you can see that the force of attraction is between the molecule. The force of attraction between this molecule and this molecule. And what type of force of attraction is this one? Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Intermolecular hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding. Okay, that means here you can see that in para nitrophenol the force of attraction is between the molecule and the next molecule. Here if you take the next molecule, OH will come here, the again O minus and H plus, again intermolecular hydrogen bonding. That means here the molecules are joined together by means of strong intermolecular hydrogen bonding. But here you can see that intramolecular hydrogen bonding. So this is stronger force of attraction, this is weaker one. That is the reason this ortho nitrophenyl is volatile than para nitrophenol. Okay, so this is the first one, nitration. A, nitration with dilute HNO3. Now B, nitration with concentrated HNO3. Okay, so nitration with concentrated HNO3. Look at here, when phenol is treated with concentrated HNO3. Phenol is treated with concentrated HNO3. Of course, the previous dilute HNO3, the reaction was carried out at room temperature. Here heating is required. So when phenol is treated with the concentrated HNO3, we get OH. Here is OH, here is NO2, here is also NO2, and here is also NO2. You are getting, here is concentrated HNO3, you are getting 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. What you are getting? 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. It is known as picric acid. Picric acid. This is a picric acid. Okay, this is very important compound, mainly used for the production of explosives. That is the main use of picric acid for explosive, and in medical field also for preparing antiseptic, etc. This picric acid is used. So keep it in mind, when phenol is treated with the concentrated HNO3, what we get 2,4,6 trinitrophenol, which is known as picric acid. Now this method of preparation of picric acid, the yield of picric acid is very less, because when we use concentrated HNO3, the phenol will undergo oxidation. Instead of changing into 2,4,6 trinitrophenol or picric acid, the phenol will undergo oxidation. That means the yield of picric acid will be less if we go for a direct nitration with the concentrated HNO3. Therefore, for better yield of picric acid, first we are sulfonating phenol using concentrated sulfuric acid. Then on nitration, we get better yield of picric acid. So first we do sulfonation with concentrated H2SO4. That means phenol is treated with concentrated H2SO4. First we are treating with the concentrated H2SO4. We get you can see that ortho-hydroxy, here it is SO3H, ortho-hydroxy sulfonic acid and para-hydroxy sulfonic acid, both we get this hydroxy sulfonic acid. Okay, plus what we get? Okay, we will write that also, OH SO3 H. This is ortho hydroxy sulfonic acid. This is para hydroxy sulfonic acid. This on treatment with the concentrated HNO3. Concentrated HNO3. Okay. Now this is undergoing nitration. Okay. Or hydroxy sulfonic acid. Hydroxy sulfonic acid on nitration will get. We get again. We get picric acid. That means 2,4,6. 2,4,6 trinitro phenol. 2,4,6 trinitro phenol. Okay, this is for the better yield of 2,4,6 trinitro phenol. So first sulfonation of phenol followed by nitration. Or that's all about nitration. So nitration, there are two types of nitration. Nitration with dilute HNO3, what we get a mixture of ortho nitrophenol and para nitrophenol. Nitration with the concentrated HNO3, what we get picric acid 2,4,6 trinitrophenol. Okay, second reaction is bromination. Bromination. Okay, yeah. Reaction with bromine water. Bromine water. Okay, when phenol is treated with bromine water, that means 3Br2 aqueous bromine water. Okay, when the phenol is treated with bromine water, we get here it is OH, Br, Br, and here also Br. What we get? 2,4,6 tribromophenol. 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Okay, when phenol is treated with aqueous bromine or bromine water, what we get? 2,4,6 tribromophenol. And B, reaction with liquid bromine. There is no moisture, there is no water. Liquid bromine. Okay, reaction with the liquid bromine. When phenol is treated with bromine, Br2 liquid. In presence of carbon disulfide CS2 or CCl4, when phenol is treated with bromine liquid, in presence of carbon disulfide or carbon tetrachloride CCl4, okay, we get a mixture of ortho bromophenol plus para bromophenol. Okay. Here it is OH and here it is Br. Okay, orthobromophenol and parabromophenol. This is bromination. First one is reaction with bromine water. When phenol is treated with bromine water, what we get? 2,4,6 tribromophenol. So, you can see that what is eliminating here? This is electrophilic substitution reaction. If 3 bromine are coming here, means 3 hydrogen atoms are eliminated. That 3 into 2, there are 6 bromine atoms. 3 are joining to the ring, remaining 3 bromine, and here you can see that 3 hydrogen atoms are removed, H plus are removed, that will join with the Br. 3 Br are there, so what we will get? 3 HBr. Okay, of course that you know. Then reaction with the liquid bromine. When phenol is treated with bromine liquid, at this reaction temperature is okay, you can say 0 degree Celsius. Okay, react with the bromine liquid in presence of here the solvent is carbon disulfide or carbon tetrachloride. We get orthobromophenol and parabromophenol. Okay. Third one, sulfonation. Sulfonation means a reaction with the concentrated sulfuric acid. So when phenol, when phenol is treated with phenol is treated with the concentrated H2SO4, concentrated H2SO4, what we get? We get a mixture of okay, here it is OH and here it is SO3H ortho hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid and para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid, okay, OH SO3H, okay, para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid, that's all. So sulfonation, when phenol is treated with concentrated H2SO4, we get a mixture of ortho hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid and para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid. Okay, next is important reaction, that is Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Next reaction of phenol is Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Okay, this is important. Riemer-Thiemann reaction. What is Riemer-Thiemann reaction? Reaction of phenol with chloroform and NaOH, chloroform and NaOH, sodium hydroxide, followed by acid hydrolysis, will give salicylaldehyde. Okay, so this is Riemer-Thiemann reaction. What is Riemer-Thiemann reaction? Reaction of phenol with the chloroform and NaOH followed by acid hydrolysis will give salicylaldehyde. Okay, look at here the reaction. This is phenol is treated with chloroform CHCl3 and NaOH followed by acid hydrolysis H2OH+, and the reaction temperature is 70 degrees Celsius. Phenol is treated with the chloroform and NaOH followed by acid hydrolysis at a temperature of 70 degrees Celsius. What we get? We get salicylaldehyde. Okay, look at here. What is salicylaldehyde? Here is OH, and in the ortho position there is CHO. So what is this one? Ortho hydroxy. So what is this compound? This is benzaldehyde. So what is this one in the ortho position? Hydroxyl group. Ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, which is known as salicylaldehyde. Ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, which is known as salicylaldehyde. Okay, so this is very important reaction. Where reaction of phenol with the chloroform and aqueous NaOH followed by acid hydrolysis, we get salicylaldehyde, phenol, chloroform, NaOH, H2H+, 70 degrees Celsius, or ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, which is known as salicylaldehyde. Again, the same Riemer-Thiemann reaction. Instead of chloroform, if we use carbon tetrachloride, what is that? Carbon tetrachloride. So, Riemer-Thiemann reaction, phenol with CCl4, chloroform, if we use carbon tetrachloride, CCl4, carbon tetrachloride, instead of ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, we get here instead of CHO, we get COOH. That means salicylic acid. Okay. So this is the also Riemer-Thiemann reaction. So keep it in mind, when phenol is treated with the carbon tetrachloride instead of chloroform, but we get ortho hydroxy benzoic acid, which is known as salicylic acid. Clear? So when we use chloroform, we get salicylaldehyde. When you use carbon tetrachloride, we get salicylic acid. This salicylic acid is important for the preparation of aspirin. You may have heard about aspirin. It is a painkiller, or it can reduce fever, pain, etc., inflammation, etc. So this salicylic acid is very important for the production of the medicine aspirin. So look at here how we are preparing aspirin from salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is treated with acetic anhydride. Salicylic acid is treated with acetic anhydride. What is the formula of acetic anhydride? CH3COOCH3. Okay, or you can write it as, what is that? CH3CO. Here also CH3CO. CH3CO twice. O. Correct. Acetic anhydride. What is the general formula of anhydride? RCOOCOR. Acetic anhydride, CH3COOCOCH3. Or you can write it as CH3CO, CH3CO. CH3CO twice. Oh, okay. Now look at here, salicylic acid. OH, COH, salicylic acid is treated with acetic anhydride, CH3COOCOCH3. Okay, acetic anhydride. And what will happen? You can see that, okay, suppose the bond is breaking here. Okay, look at it here. The bond is breaking here. And the OH bond is also breaking. And you can see that here it is OH. Okay, this is OH. And this bond also breaking. Okay, here it is breaking. And this bond is breaking here. And what will happen? This CO, this side, CH3CO group will attach to oxygen. And the H will go with this oxygen. Okay, the bond is breaking here. So what do we get? Look at it here. Okay, here this COH group, no change. It is as it is. And what will come here? Here is your O is here. And to that O, which part will come? This part, CH3CO part. So what do we get? CO CH3. Okay, correct. Plus what will form? CH3CO. O, that O will join with H, so that means acetic acid, CH3COOH. Okay, this is aspirin. This is acetyl salicylic acid. What is aspirin? Acetyl salicylic acid, which is known as aspirin. It is used for pain or fever or inflammation remover. Okay, so keep it in mind. This is our salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is treated with acetic anhydride, and what we get? OH. Okay, the COH group, no change. OH bond breaks here, and CH3CO, okay, breaking here. Then what will happen? This CH3CO part, this part is joining with O, so OCOCH3. Remaining part is CH3COO, the removed H is joining with this one. So what do we get? CH3COOH, acetic acid. Okay, so this is our acetyl salicylic acid, which is known as aspirin. Okay, next class we discuss the mechanism of Riemann-Thiemann reaction. Okay, so today in this class we have studied the reactions of phenol. First one is nitration. Nitration with dilute HNO3 at room temperature, we get orthonitrophenol and paranitrophenol. Orthonitrophenol is more volatile than paranitrophenol, because in orthonitrophenol the force of attraction is weak intramolecular hydrogen bonding, but in paranitrophenol the molecules are joined together by means of intermolecular hydrogen bonding. And the second one is nitration with concentrated HNO3. When we do nitration of phenol with the concentrated HNO3, we get 2,4,6 trinitrophenol or picric acid. It is used for making explosives. And since if we directly use concentrated HNO3, the phenol will undergo oxidation instead of changing into picric acid. Therefore, first what we do, the phenol is treating with the concentrated H2SO4 and we get ortho hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid and para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid. This hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid on nitration, on treatment with the concentrated HNO3, we get 2,4,6 trinitrophenol or picric acid. Then next one is bromination. First one is bromination with aqueous bromine or bromine water. When we do bromination of phenol with bromine water, Br2 aqueous, we get 2,4,6 tribromophenol. Now B, bromination with liquid bromine in presence of carbon disulfide or carbon tetrachloride, we get a mixture of orthobromophenol and parabromophenol. Third one is sulfonation. When benzene is treated with the concentrated sulfuric acid, phenol is treated with the concentrated sulfuric acid. As we have discussed earlier, what we get? We get orthohydroxy benzene sulfonic acid, that means OH, and in the ortho SO3H. What is the formula of benzene sulfonic acid? Ring SO3H. Okay, orthohydroxy benzene sulfonic acid and para hydroxy benzene sulfonic acid. Okay, and the last one is the fourth one is Riemann-Tiemann reaction. The reaction of phenol with the chloroform and NaOH followed by acid hydrolysis, we get salicylaldehyde. We get salicylaldehyde. That means when phenol is treated with the CHCl3 NaOH H2OH+ at 70 degrees Celsius, what do we get? We get OHCHO, ortho hydroxy benzaldehyde, which is known as salicylaldehyde. Instead of chloroform, if we use carbon tetrachloride, what we get? We get salicylic acid, that means OHCOH, that means ortho hydroxy benzoic acid, salicylic acid. Now that's preparation of aspirin. We can prepare aspirin from salicylic acid by the treatment of salicylic acid with the acetic anhydride. What is salicylic acid? Salicylic acid is acetyl salicylic acid, which is known as aspirin. Acetyl salicylic acid, which is known as aspirin. Okay, and thank you.